my family being friendly. It's an organization from Israel, so I actually came here all the way from Israel to give this talk. Is anybody here by chance from Israel? Okay. Cool. Since I assume that some of you here are not familiar with our activity, we made a very short video that will show you all about who we are and what we do. So just
Vegan Friendly is an up-and-coming organization that works vigorously to promote and improve vegan lifestyle. The organization was founded in 2012 and since launched a large number of revolutionary campaigns. We work in two main fields, making vegan lifestyle accessible by encouraging businesses to add vegan options, labeling vegan products with the official logo, and producing huge events for thousands of participants every year. Moreover, we in Vegan Friendly work towards raising awareness about the cruelty in factory farming. This we do by launching pioneering and innovative campaigns in a variety of fields, such as billboards, food engineering, educating the youth, and much more. We in Vegan Friendly believe that the vegan dream can become a reality, that veganism is beneficial, saves lives, and belongs to us all. For every one of us, for our health, for the planet, and for the animals' welfare.
Specifically, I want to talk about a very interesting model we created just last year called Vegan Active. But let's start from the beginning. When I became vegan many years ago, when I was still young and handsome, I was very passionate about animal rights. Can anybody here relate to that? Yeah, cool. So I was one of those annoying people that would get into fights with all his friends and family. I went to all the vegan events and demonstrations. I even started going to the supermarket naked. That doesn't have anything to do with veganism. What I did do was establish Vegan Friendly, which is a nonprofit organization. And I had lots of ideas and things that I wanted to do. For example, I wanted to have a huge vegan billboard on the biggest and busiest highway in the country. But to do that, of course, we needed money, right? So we didn't do that. I also wanted to have a massive animal rights march, bringing tens of thousands of people, maybe even 300,000 people, out to the streets shouting animal liberation. But that is all we need for that, a lot of money, right? We also wanted to make veganism as accessible as possible, encouraging businesses to add lots of vegan options all over the country. But yet again, that requires a lot of money. So in the beginning, we didn't do all that. What we did was local activity, but even for that, after like a year, we realized that we need funds, right? So we realized that we need to raise funds. We had a pretty big social media, and so we posted for all the followers, asking for them to support our activity. And after a couple of days, we even boosted the post, so we get a big reach. And after a couple of days, can you guess how much money we managed to raise? Just throw a number. How much?
$300.
Pretty close. And a full $875. And I was really insulted, actually, because it was the first time that we asked for money from the followers, and I was expected more. I thought maybe it was even a mistake, and we would, Facebook Analytics, and that one makes
algorithms.
Algorithm. Yeah, so we posted again, and this time we got $200. So we realized that maybe we need to change, the strategy. So we sat down and thought, what can we do to generate money to the organization so we can continue being active and even grow? And we came up with an idea to create win-win models that will benefit everybody, kind of like with business models. I'll give an example. So for example, we wanted veganism to be accessible and encourage businesses to have vegan options, right? So what we did was we created a certificate, a vegan friendly certificate, in and we approached the businesses and told them, look, if you want to get the amazing vegan friendly certificate, you're going to have to add lots of vegan options. And you're going to pay us. In return, we're gonna advertise you to all the vegan movements, so they'll know the options. Mm. And this way, you're gonna get a lot of money. So we kind of build a win-win model, in which we're generating money, advertising the options to the vegans, making it more accessible because now they know about more options, and the businesses get more customers. We did the same thing with food manufacturers. We asked them to add the vegan-friendly logo to the products, and again, pay us for using the certificate. We advertised the vegan options to the vegans. They knew about more vegan options, bought more vegan products, and the businesses gained as well. We also had very big events throughout the year for thousands of people to show how amazing a vegan lifestyle can be, how much vegan food is just great. As you notice in the conference, just amazing vegan food. No, just kidding. But obviously, it takes a lot of money, right, to raise these events. So we charge admission, sponsors, and we also charge money from the food stands, so we can sponsor the activity. And from 2012 until 2014-15, veganism has thrived in Israel. We managed to bring up a percentage from only 1% to 5% in only a couple of years. Obviously, with the help of God. With the help of many other great organizations. And it was thriving so much that we had a feeling, it felt like we can just sit all day and eat avocado and hummus in the morning and become vegan in just a couple of years. But then at the end of 2016, we got a couple of surveys showing that yes, it's true that the amount of vegans leaked in the first couple of years, but since, there wasn't a big change. So we realized that we have to start working on a much bigger scale to continue on creating new vegans, like launching huge projects for that. And to do that, of course, we're going to have a lot of money, right? So we sat back down again and thought, how can we generate a large amount of money in a very short period of time towards the projects? And we came up with a model, it took us 3 months, called Vegan Active. In 1 year, we generated $300,000 and managed to launch 5 national campaigns that reached millions of people all over the country. Would you like to see the campaigns?
Yes!
Vegan Active זה פרויקט פורץ דרך. אני לא חושב שהוא נעשה אי פעם בעולם, אבל המהלך שלו הוא די פשוט. כן? לרכז את כל המאמצים, המשאבים שלנו, לעשות דברים באמת באמת גדולים שמעולם לא נעשו.
המאבק של הקהילה הטבעונית מעלה מאתמול הילוך עם
שילוט חוצות שבדרך כלל נשמר לחברות ענק.
כשנועד לחשוף בפנינו את הצדדים הפחות נעימים לטענתם של תעשיית מוצרי החלב.
Holy sh**, I'm actually in a cage. What the hell? Oh my god.
אני כן שמחה באיזשהו מקום שהראו לי את זה, כי זה פשוט להפסיק את הבורות.
So how do we do it? How does the model work exactly, right? So basically, we encourage people to join as members, to begin active. To become a member, you need to donate at least $10 a month. It's a monthly donation. The donation goes directly to a specific project that you choose. You can always choose between three different projects. And each project is exactly like a Kickstarter, that you can see how much money you need to raise, how much money has been raised, or the goal of the project, how many animals it's going to save. And when the campaign reaches its goal, then we launch it, and a different campaign replaces it. Now, as I'm sure you know, it's very difficult to get on board people with a monthly donation, right? Yeah. So what we did was, to give them an incentive, we created a lifestyle club for all the members, that they'll get discounts and benefits of between 10 and 50% every time they use the card as vegan active members. And it's with hundreds of businesses all over the country, places that they eat at anyways, so like restaurants and whatever. So it basically, it's enough for them to use the card twice, maybe three times a month, and they're getting back all the money that they're donating. You can actually save money by donating money to these projects, which I think is pretty much amazing. So what we basically did was we figured out what were the three main things that are the most important to people when they visit the model. It looks like, see, also here we build a win-win model. So we get money from the members, they get back money from the discounts, we get the discounts from the businesses, and the businesses get back money from the members because now they have new customers using the coupon. It's the coupon model. And so we took what are the main motivators for people to donate. First one, to donate directly to a project and not to the organization. We always have a feeling like it just goes to a black hole when you donate to an organization. And second, make them feel like they're part of something really big. So each project has to be something big, revolutionary, something that has never been done. And the third, give them something back. We don't have to think about it, but the truth is that people also want to get things back, right? So before we started being active, from 2012 to 2017, did anybody guess how much money we generated from monthly donations every month? Just curious. 500? 20 months? 25? And we actually generated a cool $285 a month, right? In 1 year, since we started being active, we managed to generate $30,000 every month for the project. We're actually able now to launch a national project every 3, maybe even 2 months, and it affects, reaches millions. Now, our ultimate goal is, this is a bit complicated, I hope you'll stay with me, to get to 6,000 members, which will generate $100,000 every month, which will allow us to launch a campaign every month, which will hopefully veganize about 5,000 people. 5,000 people a month, that's 60,000 vegans a year, which is almost a percentage, 1% of the population in Israel. So our goal is to add a percentage of 1% of vegans every year until 2025. We'll get to 10% of the population, hoping that that will allow us to get to critical mass. Mm-hmm. And critical mass, when we get to that point, hopefully it will be enough to generate the national momentum towards the rest of the population. Woo! Well, I'm guessing that some of you, after hearing this, think to yourself, hopefully, well, this actually makes perfect sense, you know, they have a model, they have to give coupons, makes sense. I'm sure that some of you are thinking, this guy is completely crazy. But what I can tell you is that because of the vegan active model and all the members, we already know now that in the next year, we're going to be having all these amazing events. So in just 2 weeks from now, we're going to have a national campaign of the commercials on the radio, all the major stations. And right after that, we're going to have, this is pretty interesting, it's a food engineering project. We're going to hire a vegan food engineer that will consult food manufacturers how to replace the animal ingredients from the products without it affecting the price, the taste, or the quality of the product. And this way we can probably save millions of animals every year if it's successful. And right after that, we're going to hire a vegan lobbyist to advocate for animals in the Israeli parliament. And right after that, we're going to launch an extremely effective lecture, kind of like the Yourofsky lecture that you probably know, and promote it on all social media for it to get to 10 million views. And right after that, we're going to launch for the first time ever a campaign of vegan commercials on television, which is pretty much amazing. So to conclude, today we talked about unique ways to raise funds for the organization, and especially put an emphasis on Vegan Active, which I believe is a revolutionary and can be a game changer model for the vegan movement, which struggles all the time to raise money for the projects. But even if people sitting here be not able to use any of the specific models that we talked about, I would like to take from this lecture these three things, okay? One, we have to remember that raising money is essential. The more money we raise, more or less, the more animals we save. This is something we have to remember. Second, don't try only to fundraise from individuals, from vegans. Also think about businesses, for example, that's also a big potential to raise money. And third, think outside the box. The models we showed you today are not applied in almost any organization, and I wish they would. We think a lot of times that because our cause is so important, then people will just throw money on us, but that's not the truth, right? So we always need to think outside the box to continue on raising money for the important cause. And I want to wish everybody here a lot of luck. Next year we'll be raising money for your organization and for your projects, and thank you very much.